Welcome back. We'll be starting with the final chapter for class 10th economics, that's related to consumer rights. Now, when we talk about market, there are two role players, the producers and the customers, or the consumers, we can say. Now, producers are basically focusing on two sectors, the organized sector and the unorganized sector. So the producers who are working with the organized sector have a kind of protected job. However, there is job insecurity with the unorganized sector. So it's important to protect the labor in the unorganized sector. On the other hand, you have customers or consumers who are the driving force. So these consumers try to use the product from the producers. And if there is a kind of satisfaction in the quality demanded, if that does not meet, it leads to consumer kind of redressal that they need to work around. So they need to work for their own rights. As a result, you have the consumer movement that started. Now, as we said, first of all, the major reason is the satisfaction. So if there is no satisfaction with the customers or the consumers, they would start a drive against the producers over the illegal trade practices. So there should be a kind of legal system to protect them. Of late till 1950s, there was no legal system that protected the consumers in the market. Now again, there is a shift in the responsibility to ensure the quality of goods and services. So let's say I am buying a pack of Amul milk from a shop. Now if this pouch is rotten for any case or is not in the perfect form, what I would do is I would tell the shopkeeper. But is he the right person to address the issue? He is obviously not the right person. Who is directly responsible to it would be the Amul factory. So what does that mean? That means there is a kind of shift in the responsibility which takes place in the role of quality of the services and the goods that are being provided. Again, adulteration in case of food items, you have hoarding, you have black marketing of the supply that goes into the PDS. So all the supply that goes into the public distribution system at a subsidized price is led into the open market at a higher price, and there is a kind of profit that is generated by the middlemen. And to rule out all these, you have the customer movements that started. So it was an idea to curb the black marketing and the hoarding, to work on the existing food shortages. Till 1970s, the major way of agitation was writing articles, holding exhibitions, and showing your revenge in one form or the other. However, later there were consumer groups that were formed, and these consumer groups, what they tried to do was the only thing that they could think of or they could work around was overcrowding the existing place. So let's say if it's a ration shop which is providing the PDS commodity, the public distribution through the public distribution chain, the fair price shops, what they would do is they would overcrowd that, saying that there has been malpractices going on at your ration shop. But this is not how the consumer should really go. As a result, there was a kind of social force that started and a social movement came up. The idea was to protect the customers. So in 1985, United Nations laid down the guidelines for protection of consumers. Under this, Consumer International was established, which included 240 organizations across 100 nations. And as a result of this, in India, the drive came into force. It was known as COPRA, that's the Consumer Protection Act, and it was launched in 1986. The basic idea was creating awareness in the consumers. So let's say if I am joining a coaching institute for some competitive examination, I am doing a lump sum down payment of say rupees 60,000. Now this was for a period of 2 years. After 6 months, I realized that the staff teaching in that coaching institute is not at par, and I do not want to be associated with this coaching institute. So I go to the staff and say, deduct my money for 6 months and refund me the remaining amount. Now this coaching institute denies the refund. What would happen? As a customer, I have the right to approach the consumer court. So this is how you have a kind of basic framework where and how to apply or how the consumers can fight for their rights. So let's say there is another example of medical negligence. So a person was administered anesthesia, and as a side effect of that anesthesia, the person suffered from crippling. Now the caretakers of the person went to the National Consumer Dispute Redressal and they asked for a kind of reimbursement or the compensation for that. So that is again a kind of consumer right which comes under this COPRA Act. So safety is everyone's right. The producers must strictly follow the safety rules. So for example, if we take a simple example of pressure cooker, it has safety walls. So if it does not have a safety wall and it does not meet the given guidelines, it should not be allowed in the open market. So as a customer, what all things should we look for? So let's say if I am buying a tablet, a medicine, I would look for date of manufacturing, I would look for date of expiry, I would look for the MRP, the batch number. So these are some of the common things that you look for. Besides that, the ingredients or the composition for any food article or medical articles, the directions of use, the address of the manufacturers. So these are something that as a customer, I have the right to look for. So let's say if I want to buy a toothpaste and I go to the market, what would happen? To buy a toothpaste, the shopkeeper tells me, I have a toothpaste for 50 rupees and you can buy it only if you purchase a toothbrush along. Now as a customer, I have the right to deny, saying that I do not want this toothpaste along with a toothbrush and I only want a toothpaste which might cost me only rupees 20. So as a customer, I have the right to deny the use of the product that he is selling in the market. So similarly, you have all the informations that should be mentioned. For example, if it is garment, you must have an instruction for washing. If it is medicine, you must have the information on side effects. So these are the things that a customer has the right to look for, and based on that, he can decide whether he want to go for a certain commodity or not. Again, the customer has the right to be informed. He can complain. In case he has suffered some losses because of it, he can ask for compensation. In certain cases, recall of articles can also be done. Now in 2005, RTI was released, so the Right to Information Act asked about providing citizens the information that they require from the various government departments. So for example, if I have the right to choose a service, what I can do is, I am doing supposedly my research work and I want to get a data from say the urban planning department of the region. What would happen? The department denies me providing the data, but as a customer there, I have the right to information, and based on the RTI, I can file an RTI against the department saying that I require this data which the department is not willing to provide. So this is a kind of example where you have the right to choose the services that you have and so on. Now next is seeking justice. So as a customer, again, you have the right to seek the redressal whenever you feel there are unfair trade practices. So providing financial support. Now again, when you are dealing the cases under COPRA, it comes under three heads, the consumer protection rights. It's at the district level, state level and national level. So let's say I am residing in an urban area and I have my close relatives and my near and dear ones in the village. I am sending the money order, I am earning in the urban area, I am sending the money order to the family there to support them. And for some case, the money order does not reach there. What I will do is, I will go to the post office inquiring why it does not reach. Then again, I might receive a reply that we don't know what the problem was, where it was struck up. So what would ultimately happen is, I would file a consumer complaint stating that the money order was sent for this amount and it has not been received in the village till now. So these are the cases where you can go for and seek justice. So under COPRA, as we said, you have three limits. Under the district court, you would file cases up to rupees 20 lakhs. Under the state, you have the right to file up to 20 lakhs to 1 crore, and more than 1 crore rupees, you would file under the National Court of COPRA. Now, as we said, we have to discriminate, and whenever we are discriminating, we are making, or we are a kind of informed citizen who has the right to choose. So given the choices A, B, C, I have the right to opt for the one that I feel is the best. Again, to maintain the quality, government has come up with some regulatory standards. So for example, Agmark is a regulatory standard for agricultural products. Hallmark is for jewelry products and ISI is for electronic products. Similarly, to focus or to help customers enhance their rights, 24 December is celebrated as the National Consumer Day. Now, what all are covered under COPRA? As we said, you have the right to be protected, you have the right to be informed, you have the right to be assured, to be heard of, to seek redressal, and finally, the right to consumer education. So these are the basic six rights that as a consumer you must have, and you can go to court or you can move to court if these are not fulfilled or not answered at a given point. So with this we cover the class 10th economics completely. We'll be pursuing more topics in economics and the contemporary issues in the upcoming lectures. You can subscribe to our channel for more updates. Have a good day ahead.